Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about heel and toe downshifting, what it is and why it's done. So first we're going to talk about the process itself, how it's done, and then we're going to look inside your transmission and talk about why this is done. And really this is used to downshift while you're on the brakes. So let's say you're coming into a corner, you're on the brakes, you want to downshift so you can exit that corner and accelerate out with a better gear. And so you want a smooth transition in doing so. And so this is the process for doing that. So obviously first you're going to have your foot on the brake. And so you're going to press and hold and you're going to be on that brake for this entire process. So the next thing you're going to do is press in your clutch. Then simultaneously you're going to downshift. So in this scenario we're going from fourth gear to third gear. And then you're going to roll your foot over. So there's a couple ways this is done, and it kind of depends on the pedal spacing. If the pedals are really close together, you can simply have your foot and then just kind of roll it over onto the throttle. If it's spaced further apart, then you may end up rotating and using your heel, which is how it gets the name heel and toe. You rotate over and tap the accelerator with your heel. And then once you've raised up the engine speed, you release the clutch and you have a nice smooth transition. So what's actually happening inside your vehicle? So here we have our engine connected up with the flywheel and the pressure plate surrounding the clutch. That's giving us our input shaft there, which is going over to the lay shaft. We've got our gears 3 and 4, and here's our output shaft with the collar. Here's our gear linkage here, so we're shifting with our shift lever here. If we push it forward, it shoves it into third. If we pull that back, it puts it into fourth. And there's our differential and wheel. So the process here, the first thing, basically what you want to understand is that everything in each individual color can rotate individually. So red can rotate by itself, which is the engine and flywheel and pressure plate. Blue can rotate by itself, the gears and the lay shaft. And green can rotate by itself, your wheels up to the collar of the transmission, which is on the output shaft. Now these, while you are in fourth gear and driving along, all of these are rotating together. So they're all synchronized here. Now, what changes when we press in the clutch is now we've detached the engine from all of this. So green and blue are still rotating with each other, but red is not rotating with it. Now we shift from fourth to third, so we bring this collar out of fourth gear and press it into third. So what that does is it changes what your clutch is spinning with. So your clutch was spinning with fourth gear, now it's going to be spinning with third gear, so obviously that's going to raise its speed. So now the clutch is rotating faster than the engine. So you've got this speed which is high because it's connected to the wheels, and then you've got this speed which is low because it's been disconnected from everything. So what you're going to do is roll onto that throttle, bring the engine speed up to the clutch speed, so it matches that third gear's speed, and then release the clutch. And then you have a very smooth transition. So why is this done? Well, two main reasons. First of all, you're going to be saving your clutch because you don't have a speed differential between the flywheel and the clutch when they engage, so you're going to be saving your clutch. And the other thing, and probably more importantly, is you're going to have a smooth transition. You're not going to upset the balance of the car. So if you were to, let's say you're in a front-wheel drive car and you're coming into a corner, and instead of blipping the throttle here, you simply just release the clutch. Well, then you're going to be placing a braking force which is going to pass to your driven wheels. So if you're in a front-wheel drive car, that's going to increase the slip angle of your front wheels, and that's going to give you a tendency to understeer. If you were to do the same thing in a rear-wheel drive car, well, then you're going to be passing that force to the rear wheels, braking them, so you're going to increase the rear wheel slip angle, and then you're going to be more likely to oversteer. Now, if you were to do that in an all-wheel drive vehicle, you're going to be applying a braking force to all four of your wheels if you don't match the throttle, the engine speed to the clutch speed. And so by passing that braking force to all your wheels, you're going to be more likely for that car to slide, or it could understeer or oversteer depending on where most of that braking force is applied. So hopefully that clears up heel and toe downshifting. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those below. Thanks for watching. Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about what is double clutching when referring to the driving technique. So we're going to talk about what the process of it is and then talk about why it's necessary. And it's really only necessary with cars which don't have synchronizers with a manual transmission. And so I think the why question is the part that kind of confuses people the most, that's the most difficult to understand. But first let's go ahead and walk through the process.